Starting out on 3D production, especially in animated film, one thing was known for sure: it would generate a lot of files. From various documents to a gallery of concept art, which gets turned into a mass of 3D software files with associated image textures, resulting in thousands of rendered frames. So how does one organise it all? I'm glad you asked. For any naming system, the first requirement is to establish what character and symbols we just shouldn't use. For example, on some Mac systems, you may well be able to create a folder like this, but try to access or work with that folder, and the forward slash would just cause a world of pain. So in the interest of broad compatibility, the following characters are illegal for folder and file names in Windows, and likely a bad idea for other operating systems as well. In addition, there are a group of other characters that could have a special meaning in some software or operating systems, and hence are also best to avoid. Lastly, we come to the issue of using spaces in names. While their use does make readability much easier, there is a possible downside. It's not unheard of for some software or systems to read and display a space as %20, and then save a file using the code rather than an actual space, at which point all sorts of things will likely stop working. The solution is to use an underscore in place of a space, resulting in a name that is still readable while avoiding possible issues. With our character set established, we can now define what exactly it is we are naming. In general, there are three main levels of organization: folders, which are used to group similar tasks or elements together in a logical and consistent order; files, which needs to easily identify the type and purpose of the file, along with a version status; and components within various files, like objects or shaders in Blender, with a more useful name than box or material. For the purpose of this video, we will only be having a general look at folders. There are many ways to structure a project, however, most productions go through five main phases: development, pre-production, production, post-production, and distribution. Unless you are working on a large movie with various copyright or legal issues, then any minor development work can just be covered under pre-production. That leaves us with four top-level folders, which, along with a project name, gives us this initial structure. The first thing to note is the use of prefix numbers to control the order of the folders. This becomes more important at lower depths of the structure, as it's used to ensure that the same purpose of any given file is always to be found in the same consistent location. Starting with pre-production, there's a large number of possible subfolders, but in general, the following five should cover most stages: a script folder, which contains various story ideas, drafts, and final screenplay. For short projects, it would also be okay to store production files like schedules or budgets. Next is concept design, which would have all initial artwork for the project, likely collected under subfolders for things like characters, props, and environments. Then we have storyboard, the first visual look of the story from each camera shot point of view, followed by animatic, an initial edit cut of the story based on the storyboard with maybe some temp audio and voice recording. And finally, animation tests, since the last thing you want is to be deep into production, only for it to hit a wall because some cool idea in the script that looked great in concept art just isn't doable in full animation. Moving on to the production folder, this will no doubt end up with the most subfolders, files, and data for the project. Again, we have five main subfolders. Starting with assets, we have every 3D model of characters, props, and locations, along with unique textures that are needed for the project. Next is layout, which links all of those assets and places the camera for each shot of the project ready for animation. Voice recording has all of the final dialogue audio for each shot. Shots then brings it all together, where final animation, simulation and lighting are done and prepared for rendering, at which point renders then contains the raw image of every shot for final assemble in post-production. Let's have a bit of a closer look at the assets folder. Initially, there would be folders for characters, props and locations. Then under each of those is the item's name, like Fred if it's a character, followed by a set of five common folders. At the top is final. This contains the single latest version of the model. It is always called the same file name, and it is the only file that is linked throughout the production. Next is reference. Outside of any concept art, this contains any specific material that can aid in the creating of the asset. The working folder has every version of the 3D model, with the most recent version being copied into the final folder. Textures contains both the working and final versions of any unique images used on the asset, while renders has various progress images of how the asset looks. If we move on to the post-production stage, there are really only three main areas to cover. The compositing folder would take any raw rendered images and combine or adjust various parts to output a final frame to be used in the edit stage. Sound design will contain any music and sound effects, along with any possible replacement dialogue or voiceovers that wasn't already recorded for the animation process. Lastly is the edit folder, which most likely only contains any file specific to the video editing software used, as all source files are linked in from various other folders. Then finally, we come to the distribution folder and its three main subfolders. Delivery will contain various formats of the final video for a range of purposes, from a very large file for Blu-ray mastering to a smaller file for YouTube upload. The marketing folder will contain all promotional material, from style guides to press releases and a social media plan. Finally, the communication folder could be used to store letters or emails to agents or film festivals. If we bring it all together, the overall folder structure looks like this. So far, while I'm still early into the project, the naming system is holding up pretty well. However, that's not to say there won't be any adjustments or additions as time goes on, but I had to start with something. In a future production diary, we will have a look at defining the naming structure for files. If you like this look behind the scenes and want to see more, or have specific questions or requests, then please click the usual YouTube buttons and or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.